Mr. Greg Yarborough.
Hi, my name is Gregory Yarborough. It's G-R-E-G-O-R-Y. Yarborough is Y-A-R-B-R-O-U-G-H. Sandra Jones is my mother. And definitely am concerned about the route that is taken through the family farm. But I want to speak tonight some of the considerations that have been given to Spectra by the county as far as minimum coverage. The county commissioners, when they were first discussing the pipeline with Spectra, they were promised that we would be able to do a 5-foot minimum coverage through agricultural land because of our subsoiling farming techniques. My understanding is they have now reneged on that, and it is up to each individual landowner to negotiate that point. They've just chosen to ignore the promises that were made. The other thing I want to speak about real quick is SONAT is very uncomfortable with all of the line crossings that Spectra has put forth, is my understanding. I understand there's 74 being proposed at the moment. The Georgia Department of Natural Resources recommended a 100-foot separation of both of these lines when it crossed rivers and other environmentally sensitive areas. We would like to see a 100-foot no cross situation instead of the 74 times that it's going back and forth. We actually feel that the line crossing that is adjacent to my mother's property is a retaliatory thing for them, for us, you know, not submitting to their authority to come and do their survey. So we definitely have some issues with the old line. Georgia DNR recognizes some issues with the old line. We want FERC to recognize those issues. And let's maintain some minimal distance, and let's maintain the minimal coverage that Spectra first agreed to. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Yarborough.